So hi guys, Jonathan Graham here for Guitar Interactive Magazine. We're at NAMM 2020. We're here with Rob at Elrick Bass. How are you doing today, buddy?
All right, how's it going?
Man, doing great. Really stoked to hear about these fantastic new products you got right behind you right now. Can you tell us a little bit about what you've got here?
Up here we've got Gold Series basses, which are bolt-on neck instruments, 6-5-4, and then in the corner here we've got a Platinum Series single cutaway, which is a through-neck constructed instrument, all hand-carved. And in the corner we've got two Icon basses, which is our split pickup style bass that was new a couple years ago. And then down here we've got our Standard Series basses, which are made with partners in Europe. It's the new jazz standard, jazz style, modern jazz style bass, and the Evolution bass. Mm-hmm. And just over here, we have something that's still a pretty new product for us. Last year, just barely in time for NAMM, we had a first generation guitar. And now this year, we've added a couple different things. We have a single cutaway neck through, which is constructed more or less like the neck through basses.
Wow.
With a fully carved body, and of course different features because it's a guitar. This is one set up just with a three position for the pickups, but also coil switches to solo the outside coils. And the first one with a tremolo. I mean, last year we had people giving us really vague feedback, like, I don't like the bridge, as their way of saying, do you have one with a tremolo? But we finally divined what it was they were asking.
And was this ash?
This is an ash body with a matte finish that shows the surface of the grain.
Yeah, really.
Yeah, so it's a little bit more of a rock, I guess.
Yeah, killer.
Look.
Now, in the UK, and, you know, for Guitar Interactive Magazine, we've had Dan Veal look at quite a few of your basses, but we've never had any of the electric guitars. Like,
yeah, I mean, this really is brand new.
Yeah.
I had them just in time for NAMM last year, but they were really just sort of, they hadn't even been properly painted.
Sure.
They were just finished with the natural finish.
Will we see these in the UK at some point?
Yeah, I mean, hopefully. Historically, most of our relationships have been with the bass guitar and boutique retailers, and so since this is still a relatively new thing, it means we're going to have to build some new relationships with more guitar-centric retailers. So we're working on that now as part of what we're doing here at the show and after the show and before the show.
Yeah.
But it's kind of breaking new ground, and getting stuff into people's hands is more challenging than it was about 15 years ago.
Yeah.
Retail has contracted quite a bit in the last decade.
And so, I think the thing is as well, is that the bass market, bass players, guitar market, there is a difference there, isn't there? People are
looking for,
you know, like you're
well, my brand will be 28 years old this year, and yet to a lot of guitar players, completely unknown.
Yeah.
Because it's a different consumer, it's a different market space. So yeah, so there'll be some challenge there in terms of creating brand awareness. Mm. Product availability beyond that. So
yeah, it is great though to see that you're bringing in these incredible woods though to electric guitars, because every time we see, you know, Dan Veal,
this was funny that I mean several years ago you didn't see that many guitars with these kinds of finishes. I think you see a lot of European builders. Mm-hmm. Started to make it a lot more commonplace, so it felt like maybe a more practical time to enter into the market with these guitars.
Yeah,
so.
No, definitely. Well, we really hope that we can get our hands on them.
Sure.
Pretty soon we'll be checking out. And where can the guys find out more information?
Elrick.com.
Thanks very much. All
right. Hey, great. Thanks for stopping by. Have a good show.